Nothing too fancy here. I was just thinking about doing some drawing in the old book. And so I did it. Today we're using a fountain pen. A Kawiko Sport is the exact model. A green one. It's a nice one. It when you put the lid on it, the lid is almost the same size as the entire rest of the body of the pen. And so you put the lid on it and it's closed and the pen is very short. And then you take the lid off and put it on the back of it. And almost doubles the length of the pen. So it's very small when it's shut in your pocket. And then you can kind of, if you ever tried drawing with a pen, or like if you've sharpened a pencil all the way down, it's very short. It's kind of hard to write with something that's very short. It has to, at least the way I hold a pencil or a pen or any writing utensil almost, it kind of has to rest against that, the crook of your hand where your thumb meets your hand right there. You know what I'm talking about? You guys know what I'm talking about? Anyways, so it's only when you put the cap of the Kawiko, I don't know, I think it's a German word. It only becomes long enough once you put the cap on the back. And then I'm drawing in this sketchbook that I've been working on for a while, which is handmade by me. And I used, for the paper, just got a sketch pad of the Crescent Render paper, because I do like that paper, but I don't really like their sketchbooks because they don't really lie flat. Even the lay flat sketchbooks they have don't really lay flat. And they don't have hardcover lay flat sketchbooks. And I can just, every little sketchbook I can ever find on the internet to buy, there's just something wrong with it. There's just one little thing. So I just had to make it myself. I just YouTubed, you know, how to make a sketchbook and followed along the steps. I had to buy some little supplies, like some leather working tools, like some really beefy needles and some, it's called like wax thread and stuff, and just tied it together. And I don't know, I love it. Yeah, you feel even a little bit more invested in a sketchbook, I think, if you've handmade it yourself. Maybe. Personally, I feel that way. I'm more than halfway through this sketchbook, filling it up from front to back. And I'm excited to finish it and fill another one up just because it feels good to fill a sketchbook. I've really only ever filled one up. No, or maybe two. I don't know. But I have that one. I have a couple of sketchbook flip through videos, but it feels good to fill it up and flip through it and just have it full. And you can flip through it later and you have all these memories associated. Sometimes I look back at a drawing I've done and I can remember where I was in my life then and what was going on, and it's really nostalgic. Kind of the same thing happens with me with music. If I listen to an old song that I listened to, like in my teenage years, oh, all these memories come flooding back. And drawing with a fountain pen like this is interesting. Some fountain pens have flexible nibs. I think they're called flex nibs. And when you press hard, there's like two little prongs that make up a fountain pen nib. And that's what the ink flows down in between. Some of them have flex nibs, and when you press down, they kind of squish out apart a little bit. And then your line can get wider. This is not that kind of nib. So the line is always a little bit more uniform, but it's still very satisfying. The other, one of my other main fountain pens that I use, the Ahab Noodler or something like that. I don't know. I can't remember the name. The one that smells really bad at first because they made it with like recycled rubber. I don't remember what it's called, but I like that one too. And that one has a flex nib. I don't know. I have a couple of other ones sitting here. This Twisby. I don't remember. I don't think this one's flex nib. Maybe it is. Right now, this one is full of the glow in the dark ink, and I need to empty it out because I really want to use it for doing regular drawings. But I also don't want to, like, can I pour this ink back into the bottle? There's, like, a lot of ink in there, and I don't want to waste it. Should I pour it into, like, some other little container? I mean, I have plenty of the ink, so I don't know why I'm being so miserly with it. I should just get over it. Anyways, how are you guys doing? I'm just sitting here, slouching. I don't have anything else to say. Let me know in the comments. I asked this on Instagram too, and a lot of people said a lot of very amusing things about what they thought. Comment what you think this drawing is an illustration of. I Not going to tell you what I think it is. Not because, mostly because I haven't really settled on one thing. But I'm very amused to see all, just the incredible variety of things that people come up with, what they think it is. Some people, you know, think, they say it's an illustration of an illustration or something like that. But then there's like all these other, just the vast variety. It's entertaining to read and amusing and interesting. It's fun to scroll through. So let me know what you think. And I'll see you guys later. Bye. Have a good one. Thanks for watching. It was just a little video of me drawing. That's all. Keeping it simple. Bye.